Then he separated the last names from the first names. He got nowhere with Homer and Ovid, so he started to concentrate on Al, Leo, and Saul. He felt quite sure there was an anagram there somewhere. He delved into his memory, dredging the very depths of his knowledge of ancient literature. Eventually, something jumped out at him. He turned to his computer and went into Google. The results took just a moment or two. Fogel leaned back in his chair and closed his eyes. Oh my God, he thought. Could this be possible? Leo, Al, and Saul. The whole thing was unbelievable. After just a few seconds, he forced himself back into action. He printed out a couple of pages and reached for his phone to call Hemmings, then thought better of it. This needed to be done face to face. On the way through the incident room, he asked Willis and Saslow to join him. They followed at once, and he could feel their eyes on his back as he strode purposefully along the corridor to Hemmings' office. Fogel was excited and, at the same time, in a state of some shock. He could feel beads of sweat forming on his forehead, and his trembling hands were clutching the freshly printed pages. Hemmings was on the phone when Fogel poked his head around his office door and asked if he could see him for a minute. Immediately, the DCI ended his call and beckoned Fogel and his two lieutenants in. Hemmings had realized immediately that something momentous was afoot. Fogel knew he was blinking behind his spectacles as rapidly as he ever had in his life. He couldn't help it. He feared that what he was about to say was going to sound crazy, so much so that he wasn't sure he could deliver it with the required conviction. "We are looking for just one man for three very different murders," he began. "The DNA results have made that virtually irrefutable. The thing is, what I think I've discovered is that our perpetrator actually thinks he is three different people. Indeed, he lives his life as three different people."